Hello and welcome to this review of the 2015 updates of the ISO 9001 and ISO 14001 standards. Both the ISO 9001 standard for quality management and ISO 14001 for environmental management are being revised, with publication being planned by ISO for 2015. They're changing due to schedule review by ISO, and also to evolve the business environment in which they operate, and also to reflect how the business environment in which they operate has evolved since their introduction. They're also changing to link to other management systems. In the year 2000, there were only two international management systems, and onwards from 2015, there are going to be 26 international management systems, including ISO 9001, 14001, 50001, and what will replace OSAS 18001. So ISO want to harmonise these standards because there's going to be 26 rather than just two. So some harmonisation is needed, which is sensible. A document called Annex SL, published by ISO, describes the framework for a generic management system. And in time, all 26, and there may be more than this in time, ISO management system standards will follow this common approach. Annex SL implements a high-level structure for all standards, identical core text between standards, and also common terms and common definitions right across the standards. The main driver for change, or a significant driver for change for ISO 14001, is a greater emphasis on the value chain. With ISO 9001 quality management standard, it's going to become more applicable to all industries, being that there's an incredibly wide range of industries now hold certification to the ISO 9001 standard. You may want to ask when you start, or how you go about the transitional period to the new standard. Well, the transitional process will be planned and managed in conjunction with your certification body. So speak to them when the new standards come out, when they're published in 2015. Your certification body will lead and coordinate the audits and time and plan the audits in line with introducing the new version of your system to meet the new requirements of the new standard. The transitional period between the current standards and the next version of the standards is likely to be 3 years, but this will be clarified on publication of the standards. With the new version of the standards planned for probably September 2015, you may want to ask, can you start now? Well, the simple answer is yes. Annex SL is already published, and draft versions of the new standard are available. So either you can rewrite your existing management systems to Annex SL, bringing in the new high-level structure and the standardised approach across all standards, or, and DIM have helped clients with this, develop new environmental management systems to the draft versions of the new standards. In 2014, DIM Limited supported a client in gaining accredited certification to the ISO 14001:2004 standard, but using a committee draft of the 2015 standard. Because the requirements of the standards will raise, there's nothing wrong with developing a system or moving your system to the draft versions. Yes, because they're draft, they may change for the final versions, but they won't penalise your current accredited certification.